Battle Royale is a topic that has been discussed on and off by the Halo community, and in today's video I want to share my two cents on the topic. Just for some context, my opinion on Battle Royale personally is I don't like it at all. I find it a very gimmicky mode, and I find Battle Royale's reward loop really unrewarding. However, I do think Battle Royale could work really well in Halo. And here's why. So at the start of every match in classic Halo multiplayer, there is a frantic rush to get the power weapons before the enemy. That rush to get as many weapons as possible is similar to Battle Royales. Halo's lore can support a Battle Royale, for example, a war game on the Infinity where Spartans would drop from orbit in ODST drop pods onto the surface of a ring. You can explain the zone closing by saying that the Covenant were glassing the ring you are on. Now that we have established that it could work within the lore, how would it actually function in gameplay? Well, you can have drop pods dropping from a ship like the Infinity, for example, and this immediately distinguishes your game from other games on the market because of the unique orbital insertion. All the other games have you parachuting down, whilst this one is, you know. And the more you can make your game different to other Battle Royale games on the market, the more that it will stand out and gain traction from like streamers, which obviously then they stream your game and then their viewers see the game and then purchase it and so on and so forth, and you kind of get this like butterfly effect. If you can make your game stand out, even in concept and presentation, you can then gain enough traction from that alone. As I mentioned previously, you have the frantic rush to get guns at the start, just like you do in regular Halo matchmaking, so that isn't much of a difference. And with all the wreck variants added in Halo 5, you can have these wreck variants scattered around the map, which would add to, you know, the rarities. You know, Battle Royale games, they have guns that are rarer and rarer, so instead of having guns that just do a little bit more damage, it's the wreck variant or the legendary version. So the legendary version of the sword is the Lancer, for example, or the legendary version of the plasma pistol is Void's Tear, and so on and so forth. Now, in terms of the zone closing, you can have Covenant ships glassing the area that you want the zone to close off. Halo has a massive advantage over Battle Royales, which is its vehicles. Halo's vehicles have always been extremely unique compared to other games. No other game has its own version of the Ghost or the Wraith or even the Mantis. It's all very unique in how they work within the sandbox, and I think if Halo Infinite is not to have sprint, this would further the impacts that vehicles would have within the Battle Royale, because with sprint you have a lower profile, you attract a lot less attention to yourself, which is crucial within a Battle Royale. So if vehicles are to reach their full potential, even just within Halo Infinite, completely outside of a Battle Royale, sprint needs to be removed. Now that's a completely different discussion, and I'm just going to stay away from that. Another thing is, with other Battle Royales, no other game, my experience, does vehicles like Halo. Even on PC, vehicles are just way more intuitively designed with their controls and stuff. I think this, yet again, is another thing Halo can use to its advantage to distinguish itself from other games like Fortnite or Warzone. And energy shields as well would be a massive departure from the permanent health loss within other Battle Royale games, because you've got the regenerated shields. I'd say keep them in a theoretical Battle Royale, but I'd also say you'd have to have a health system like Halo, CE, Reach, and 5. You have medkits on the map which you have to get to regain your health. Perhaps there should be a way to overcharge your health so that even when your shields are down, you're impervious to at least one headshot from a precision weapon. Now, in terms of the map, you have a massive opportunity with Halo's extremely iconic maps to have all the maps like dotted around. So imagine dropping in on, say, Guardian to slowly make your way out of the jungle into Blood Gulch to only get into a sniper battle with an enemy team on like the other base. That would make for a very compelling experience. So it turns out that a Halo Battle Royale would theoretically work really well. But there is a difference from theoretically and in practice. And I think this is where the key difference happens, because for a vast majority of Halo's hardcore audience, the people who buy the books, the comics, and the people who are already saving up for like the 200 quid version of Halo Infinite, like me, this is the last chance they're going to give to Free for Free. So Free for Free really cannot mess this up. And I think that is why Halo Infinite shouldn't have a battle royale, even though a Halo battle royale could work. And the reason is because they need to nail practically every single feature in this game. They have to nail the combat. And I don't mean just like gunplay, I mean like they have to make the decision between classic gameplay or enhanced mobility. They need to make a really compelling campaign, both in its story and its level design and enemies as well. And they also have to nail the multiplayer, which I have faith in them for at least getting the multiplayer right. I think no matter what's going to happen, we're at least going to get a very good multiplayer. They have to have Forge at launch with at least all the amazing advancements they made in Halo 5 at launch this time, not a month after. Which is another thing, they have to have Infection, Griffball, Oddball, all these game modes at launch in the multiplayer this time. And they have to have a functioning theater. They need to get all of these like perfect before they can work on any other features. And I think Battle Royale hasn't been viewed as something that isn't a trend long enough for Free for Free to do it. So what I mean by this is, after all the fan feedback they got after Halo 5, I think Free for Free are petrified to do anything that might be remotely viewed as following a trend. And because of that, they won't create a battle royale mode, because only recently I feel it hasn't been viewed as a trend. So they will not have time to implement the necessary changes to the engine. It requires a whole different method of rendering objects and stuff. If you remember back to Halo 5, over a distance, there is a massive degradation in quality of assets just so that they can hit 60 frames per second. Even with the next gen hardware, I feel like you'd still have to make significant changes within the engine to fully optimize it successfully. And that's why I believe that Halo Infinite will not have a battle royale and doesn't need one. Now, please keep your discussion civil within the comments. I think that YouTube are deleting the uncivil comments, so if you want your opinion heard, don't harass anyone. And if you like the video, do all the YouTube things that YouTubers won't shut up about.